lot, and they deceive a lot. And it is evident through every action that they've ever done with us. The truth is, ladies and gentlemen, these creatures might be from Mars, really. They claim that they are from a planet which revolves around the red star, which we call Betelgeuse. They stated that their planet was dying and that at some unknown future time they would no longer be able to survive there. This led to a second landing at Edwards Air Force Base. The historical event had been planned in advance and details of the treaty had already been agreed upon. Eisenhower arranged to be in Palm Springs on vacation. On the appointed day, the president was spirited away to the base and the excuse was given to the press that he was visiting the dentist for a toothache. President Eisenhower met with the aliens and a formal treaty between the alien nation and the United States of America was signed. We then received our first alien ambassador from outer space. His name and title, and I know it sounds ridiculous, but it's absolutely true. His name and title was His Omnipotent Highness Krill, pronounced Krill, spelled K-R-L-L-L or C-R-L-L-L. In the American tradition of disdain for royal titles, he was secretly called Original Hostage Krill, R-O-H Krill, so that Americans would not have to say, Your Omnipotent Highness.